Okay, now we're doing the we're going through the photographs. We're the ones that we just took in the studio. We're going through and we're selecting. Usually if you have like over 50, for example, 3DF Zephyr, the software that I'll be working with, right here, this app, it's free. It allows you 50 photographs. So sometimes if you have more than 50, you have to select, you have to narrow it down to 50. So this time we have, I think, 30 or a little over 30. So we don't have to really take any out of the lineup, but maybe we could at least take a look at them. And these photos are not zoomed in on. They're not cropped out. There's a lot of space, background space there. And that could be a problem in a sense. It's not focusing on the object that we want, but instead what will happen is it'll take all that information and it'll make a model of everything that it finds in the photograph. And so what that means is the way 3DF Zephyr works, it may on default, for example, it may say it's going to give you 5 million triangles max. So what will happen is it'll take all this information and it'll have 5 million triangles allotted to everything in this image, which means that you're losing some definition or resolution in your sculpture. You're sharing your triangles with the rest of the space. Now, if the photos were all zoomed in and all that was there was just the sculpture, that 5 million triangles is concentrated on the sculpture itself rather than splitting it with all the other objects in the image. So that means possibly we'll end up with the object here that has only maybe 2 million resolution or something like that. It's not the end of the world, but it's not particularly what we want. So anyway, having said that, let's go into 3DF Zephyr.